Good afternoon. I'm Cameron Clark, and I'm the director of the Indiana Department of Natural Resources. With me this afternoon is Mike Spaulding. Mike's one of the foresters within our Division of Forestry. Mike, tell us a little bit about the diversity of wildlife we have here in the backcountry area of the Yellowwood State Forest.
The diversity of wildlife inhabiting the backcountry area is quite typical of what you'd find elsewhere in our state forest system, which is a diversity of wildlife that prefer mature forests, although current research is now showing that those same species prefer a matrix of young forest and older forest mixed together.
Now there is talk that our forest management practices, particularly harvesting, could imperil the diversity that we have here in the backcountry area. Tell us why you think, or why science will tell us, that that's not true.
The nature of this particular harvest in the backcountry area is so light that the overall impacts to wildlife will be minimal. However, several benefits will occur. As the canopy is open, it will allow a greater diversity of insects to inhabit the area, a higher population of insects, which are going to be extremely valuable food sources for both the federally endangered Indiana bat and the state endangered cerulean warbler.
And is there a particular reason why we would conduct a harvest this time of year?
We do harvests in the winter time when we have a known maternity roost colony nearby, which we are aware of one in the area, and so we are going to conduct this harvest in the winter time due to that colony.
The colony would be here during the warm weather months, but not during the cold weather months, correct?
Correct. The bats inhabit these areas in the summertime. They feed here, they roost in trees here, and then prior to the fall, they travel to their wintering grounds in caves.
Great. And any other wildlife of concern in the area?
We also have, in addition to the state endangered cerulean warbler I mentioned, we do have the state endangered timber rattlesnake that inhabits this area. And those rattlesnakes can expect to see a little additional sunlight to the floors, forest floor, which will help with gravid females, and will also serve to increase the rodent population, which is their primary food source following the harvest.
And the neotropical birds that come to this area, do they like just the mature forest conditions, or do they like diversity of forest conditions?
What current research is showing is that they do in fact nest in mature trees, and they like to nest in mature trees that are also in proximity to good food sources. And so any additional light in here that can create additional food sources such as berries or insects will provide some additional food along with the already sufficient nesting habitat we have here.
Great. Mike, thank you for your time.
Thank you.